In this video, I go over the difference between Azure B2B and B2C services. Hello everyone, I'm Travis and this is Seraltos. And today I'm going over the difference between Azure Business to Business, or B2B, and Business to Customer, or B2C services. Before that, please take a second to subscribe, like, share, and click the bell icon to get notifications of new content. I chose this topic because I remember being confused by this on a couple certification exams I previously took. B2B and B2C are two different identity services, but their names are similar. I remember having this on my list of items to review while sitting in the parking lot of my testing center back when you could use testing centers. The difference is pretty easy once you understand what they're for. We'll start with B2B, but before that, let's review how Azure handles authentication and authorization. If you come from a Windows background, it's easy to think of authorization and authentication as two parts to the same thing. User objects have password hashes, defined group membership, and other security-related attributes. With Azure, Microsoft did something different. They split authentication and authorization in two. Authentication is the act of proving who you are, while authorization defines what you can do. To take things even further, an object does not need to be from the Azure AD tenant to be authenticated. Because authentication and authorization are split into two, users from other tenants can log in and get authorized to items in your tenant. That brings us to business to business. B2B allows you to share your organization's applications and services to guests from outside your organization. This allows your business to collaborate with other businesses. That's the business to business part. Users use their native identities for access to items in your tenant. Let's see how this works. A user is located in Company A. Company B is a partner with resources that they would like to share, so they send an invite to the user. The resources could be access to an Azure object or an O365 service like SharePoint or Teams. The user accepts the invite, and by doing so, a guest object is created in Company B's Azure tenant representing that user. The user is granted authorization to the resource in Company B. The user's authentication takes place in Company A, but authorization, what they can access, takes place in Company B. This works the same with public identities like Google and Outlook.com. Let's do a quick walkthrough of setting this up. Here I am at the portal, and the first thing I'm going to do is go into Azure Active Directory. From here, I'm going to go to Users. Next, I'll go to New Guest User. I'm going to invite a user. I'll give the user a name. I'll just use Travis Guest for this example. I'll give it the email address of the user. And I'll fill out the name fields. I can give a personal message. I'll scroll down. Here I can add the user to a group or assign a role. We can do that later too. If I wanted to block sign in until this has been accepted, I can set that here. I can also give it a location. This user is in the United States. And I'll give a job title. Now I'll click invite. That will send an invite to the user. I'm going to go into the account and just point out a couple things. You can see here under the identity, under invitation accepted, there's no. I can also resend the invitation if the user didn't get it or lost it for some reason. Next, I'm going to log into the user's email account and accept the invitation. Here's the invitation. I'm invited to join the default directory. I'm going to click on that. And in order to accept the invitation, I'll click on the link. This will have me sign into Microsoft.com with my Gmail account. And this will work with other public email addresses like Outlook.com, as well as enterprise email addresses. It'll ask me to review and accept permissions. I'll click accept. And now I can sign into that directory. Let's go back to the portal and see what changed. I'm going to go back to users and go into the user. Here you can see the invitation has been accepted. If I scroll down, notice I can edit these settings. So I can block sign in if I wanted to or update information on the user. Also, if I go to assign roles, I can add a role assignment to that user. Now that user is a directory reader. That's how you add and manage a business-to-business or guest account in Azure AD. Let's move on to business-to-customer. B2C provides an identity service for applications that lets customers choose how they want to log in. While B2B is for guest access to your tenant, B2C is a customizable identity solution for customer-facing applications. B2C allows customers to sign into applications by creating an account or using one they already have. External accounts could be from public emails or social media accounts such as Gmail, Facebook, or Twitter, or company IDs. Why is this important? Let's say an organization creates an application for public use. This application needs identities for logging in. To do that, they would need some kind of identity database with username and passwords. They would need to create an onboarding process for new user setup, and people forget their passwords sometimes, so they need some sort of password self-service reset. If there's sensitive information in the application, they may want to provide multi-factor authentication. This would all need to be secured yet publicly accessible for the application. Nobody wants a database of customer username and passwords to get hacked. We haven't even talked about allowing third-party identity providers like Gmail and Facebook to process logins or single sign-on. All this is provided by Azure B2C, allowing developers to spend more time on application development and less time on managing an identity service. Here's how it works. Azure B2C creates a tenant to represent the directory of users. This is similar to, but different from, an Azure AD tenant. Applications register to the tenant, and users register as local accounts or with external identities using protocols like OAuth and OpenID, or with social identities such as Twitter, Facebook, and Gmail. Flow for common tasks such as user signup or custom policies are applied to those users. There are three different types of accounts in an Azure AD B2C directory. One type is a work account. These are accounts native to the tenant used to manage the tenant and the user accounts in it. There are guest accounts. This is an external account. These are also used to manage the tenant. For example, you could invite users from your enterprise AD tenant to manage the B2C tenant. Customer accounts are the accounts users create when they sign up for the application or service. There are two types of customer accounts. Local, these are sourced from the B2C tenant, and social or enterprise identities. These are managed from external sources such as Facebook, Gmail, or ADFS. So to boil it down to one slide, the difference between B2B and B2C is that B2B allows external or guest accounts access to resources in your Azure AD or O365 environment. This is an option to allow external collaboration with O365 services such as SharePoint or Teams, allow external developers to access Azure DevOps, or give MSPs access to help administer Azure. The guest accounts can be sourced from other businesses or social accounts such as Facebook or Gmail. B2C, on the other hand, is an identity solution for applications. Developers can leverage B2C instead of creating their own solutions to manage customer identities. Unlike B2B, B2C creates a dedicated Azure AD tenant. Users can sign in by creating a local account in that directory or by using an enterprise or social media account. This was a high-level overview of B2B and B2C for those planning on taking a Microsoft Azure certification or someone who is evaluating and designing Azure solutions. There are a lot more details on each left to be explored. I'll leave some helpful links below. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.